Hello children, welcome to AIIMS India's online classes. This is biology session. You are watching Diversity of Living Organisms part 4. So very interesting lesson. We have completed some concepts related to classification. That is the need of classification and evolution. And history of classification and the classification done by biologists till date we are discussing about the Linnaeus and his contribution towards the classifications system, binomial system of classification. Okay, are you ready children? Let us proceed. Linnaeus gave each organism two names denoting genus and species, such as Homo sapiens. One example we have discussed, human being, Homo sapiens. Homo represents the genus. Okay, and the sapiens represents the species. He then grouped the genera, several genus into families, several families into orders, several orders into classes, and classes into phyla, and phyla into kingdoms. So Linnaeus identified two kingdoms, kingdom Animalia and kingdom Plantae. All the terms like species, genus, family, order, class, phyla. These terms were defined by Linnaeus on the basis of the similarities and differences studied by him in groups of organisms. Okay, this is called the taxonomic hierarchy, is the system of arranging taxonomic categories in a descending order. So it was introduced by Linnaeus in 1751, and hence it is also known as Linnaean hierarchy. Linnaean hierarchy. Okay, so each category referred to as the unit classification represents a rank and is commonly called taxa. Okay, this species, genus, family, order, class, phyla, these are all represent taxa. Okay, the term taxon was introduced but International Council of Botanical Nomenclature, ICBN, during 1956 it was introduced. Okay, so let us continue. The first major break from the Linnaean model came from Thomas Whittaker. In 1969, Whittaker proposed a five-kingdom system in which three kingdoms were added to the animals and plants. So according to him, the five kingdoms are, what are the three kingdoms added extra to the plant and animals? That is the first one, Monera, which include primitive organisms, bacteria, then protista and fungi. These are the three extra kingdoms added by Whittaker. And he is popular for five kingdom classification. Whittaker defined the kingdoms by a number of special characteristics. First, he specified whether the organisms possessed a true nucleus, that is eukaryotic. You are already familiar with this term, eukaryote. Okay, with a true nucleus or with a primitive nucleus, that is prokaryote. Okay, eukaryotic and prokaryotic. So special characteristics he considered, the first one is about the nucleus. The eukaryotic unicellular organisms were placed into the kingdom Protista. Eukaryotic unicellular organisms were placed into the kingdom Protista. That is protozoans. Okay. The rest were three multicellular eukaryotic kingdoms that distinguished themselves by the general manner in which they acquire food. Okay, he considered nutrition also. The remaining rest three multicellular eukaryotic kingdoms were distinguished by the general manner in which they acquire food. Next, plants are generally autotrophs and use photosynthetic systems to capture energy from sunlight. Animals are heterotrophs and acquire nutrients by ingesting plants or other animals and then digesting those materials. Next, come to the fungi. Fungi are also heterotrophs, but unlike animals, they generally break down large organic molecules in the environment and live on them. They are saprophytic in nature. Okay? The five kingdom system was certainly an advance over the previous system because it captured the diversity of life in a better way. Three groups, that is bacteria, fungi and protists, did not fit well into either the animal or plant category. Moreover, each of these three groups, that is bacteria, fungi and protists, appeared to possess diversity comparable to that of animals or plants. So thus, the designation of each as a kingdom seemed to be fitting. Okay, the observations or the decisions taken by the Whittaker supporting him. He separated bacteria, fungi and protists from the plants because they neither shows the plant characters completely nor the animal characters completely. So he divided them and placed it separately. That is Monera for bacteria, fungi is another kingdom separate, and protists is the another kingdom. Okay? So these are the three kingdoms added by Whittaker in his five kingdom classification. In the years since Whittaker's system was developed, however, new evidence and new methods have shown that the five kingdom system also fails to adequately capture what we know now about the diversity of life. Okay? So microbial biologists became aware of these limitations, because for every system and every concept, every hypothesis, there are some limitations, drawbacks. As here the microbial biologists became aware of these limitations as they discovered the unicellular organisms that appeared to be prokaryotic but were extremely distinct in their internal structure and other characteristics from the traditional bacteria. So some of these unusual prokaryotes lived in hot springs and other places where the temperature were near or even above the boiling point of water. They are thermophiles. They are thermophiles. Thermophiles means the organisms live in extreme hot conditions. Okay? Other are the extreme halophiles. Extreme halophiles. Halophiles means they live in extremely salty environment. Salty environments. And were able to, these halophiles are able to tolerate very high salt concentration. Okay? And acidophiles. Acidophiles means they live in acidic conditions. Okay. And even psychrophiles will be there. Okay. They live in extreme cold conditions. Psychrophiles. Okay. So other techniques like KNA sequence. KNA sequence data also increasingly suggested that these prokaryotes were most unlike and traditional bacteria. The prokaryotes are most unlike traditional bacteria. Thus, the modifications in the classification scheme came into existence. The classification is done starting from grouping living organisms into domains. For example, prokaryota, eukaryota, archaea, which form the largest categories with several dissimilar and few similar characters to species, forming the smallest category with several similar and few dissimilar characters. Okay, domains, prokaryota, eukaryota, and archaea. See the changes as we proceed in the lesson. Okay, several modifications have been done. So broadly, a species includes all organisms that are similar enough to interbreed and perpetuate or even individually reproduce. Okay, the term species was coined by John Ray, a group of organisms which are similar in structure and which can freely interbreed is called a species. Interbreed means reproduce. Next, hierarchy of classification is most important. Why do you think classification system has undergone changes over the years? Because in order to help us to understand better and better, the classification system has been undergone several changes over the years. If you were asked to classify organisms, what would be your basis of classification? No doubt, the basis of classification is the species. Now, let us study some of the characters that have been considered to classify organisms under the five kingdoms of classification. Okay, this is the hierarchy, Linnaean hierarchy. So here, life, this is the ascending order and descending order. So, as we move from top to bottom, it will become descending order. As we move from bottom to top, it will become ascending order. Okay? So let us first see the descending order. Means bigger to small. Life, it is very big. The life is divided into domains, somewhat small. Several domains are present. And several domains will form the kingdom. It is somewhat small compared to domain. Then several kingdoms combine to form the phyla. Sorry. So let us, this is a descending order. Okay, let us go from smaller to bigger. Species combine to form the genus. Genus combine to form the family. First species, it is the base of classification. In the hierarchy, it occupied the base, top. Next, the genus, several species are included in the genus, several genus combined to form the family, okay, several families combined to form the order, several orders combined to form a class, several class combined to form a phylum or a phyla, okay, and several phylum or several phyla, phyla is plural. Phyla combine to form the kingdom, and several kingdom combine to form a domain, and several domains combine to form the life. Okay? So species is the smallest unit of classification. The life is the largest unit of classification. Okay? So this is the simplest hierarchy. So now let us study the five kingdoms. First kingdom, Monera. Okay, before going to the kingdom Monera, some more. The taxonomic categories, if you see, which are always used in hierarchical classification of organisms, they are called the obligate or common categories. They are seven in number. They are mainly seven in number, these seven, from here to down. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Okay, what are they? Kingdom, phylum. Phylum is also called division also. In plants, we can call it as division. In animals, we are calling it as phylum. Okay, please remember this. Phylum or division. D-I-V. Okay. And class, order, family, genus, species. Okay. In descending order, if you see, kingdom, followed by division in plants or phylum in animals, followed by class, followed by order, followed by family, followed by genus, followed by species. Okay, this is the from top to bottom descending order. Okay, so this taxonomical aids or techniques and procedures to store the information as well as the specimens or identification and classification of organisms. Some taxonomical aids are herbarium. Herbarium is a storehouse of dried, pressed and preserved plant species or the plant specimens. Okay. The botanical gardens, they have the collection of living plants. The museums have the collection of preserved plant and animal species. Zoological parks are the places where wild animals are kept in protected areas. And key is used for identification of plants and animals. Okay, children, let us proceed. First kingdom, that is Monera. Okay, so observe the given slides. So some slides in your school laboratory, and say the following characters are observed here. The bacteria slide or picture. How many cells are found in this, the organism in the picture? It's only one cell. Do you find any nucleus in the middle of the cell? It's not specific. In the middle of cell, any nucleus? No. Okay. Are there any other cell organelles found in the cell? Yes. Some ribosomes are there. Okay. So here the DNA. Okay. Next. Monerans. So actually these monerans are one-celled organisms, unicellular organisms. The cells have no membrane. The cells have no membrane-bound nucleus. They reproduce by splitting into two. This primitive method of reproduction, we are calling it as fission or binary fission. Okay, what are the few characters? Monerans are single-celled or one-celled organisms. The cells have no membrane-bound nucleus, means there is no true nucleus. They reproduce by splitting into two, binary fission they undergo. Next characteristic feature, they absorb nutrients from outside their body. They move with the help of locomotory organs like flagella, cilia, or hair-like structures present on them. Okay, see, these are the cilia like or flagella like structures. This is the flagellum. Okay, some monerans are parasitic and cause diseases, but others are helpful to people. Okay, there are several bacteria out there which are useful bacteria. The bacteria present in our intestine, Escherichia coli, it will synthesize some vitamins. Okay, the bacteria present in the soil, free living bacteria, Rhizobium bacteria, it helps in the nitrogen fixation. Okay, so there are several bacteria out there which are useful. Even certain bacteria are used in the manufacture of antibiotics. Okay, there are three major groups of organisms come under this group Monera. What are they? They are Archaebacteria, very ancient old bacteria present till date. Next, Eubacteria. Eubacteria means they are the present Streptococcus bacteria and Rhizobium come under Eubacteria. Even Escherichia coli also come under Eubacteria category. And Cyanobacteria, here another picture is given here, no? So this is a general bacteria and this is the Cyanobacteria. Okay, the Cyanobacteria is also known as blue-green algae, blue-green bacteria. Okay, as they appear similar to blue-green algae externally, but internally are more likely they are bacteria. Okay, so that's why they are called Cyanobacteria. Anabina and Nostoc is an example of the Cyanobacteria. Okay, children, more we are going to discuss. Please read the textbook. Thank you for watching our video. Please subscribe our channel and press the bell icon for receiving latest updates.